Today in the news, we got graphics-less CPUs, the successor to the 1050, and a useless pair of APUs. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Intel. There has been some recent news about Intel expanding their 9th gen CPU line. The rumors started around the beginning of the month when Tech PowerUp saw slides of a presentation with a CPU family equipped with GT0 graphics. The CPUs were named the 9900KF, 9700KF, and 9600KF. While we know that the K for Intel means an unlocked CPU, the F stands for a processor with the iGPU disabled. That would make these chips the first core mainstream processors from Intel without integrated graphics or disabled integrated graphics since 2012. The last time they did that, we did see a bump in the frequency off the chip by about 100 megahertz. Judging by the base clock of these CPUs, it doesn't seem like we're going to get a bump this time, except for the 9400F. Is this cut down CPU a good thing? Well, yes and no. The absence of integrated graphics is likely due to a yield issue. So instead of throwing those chips away, they can sell them, which means we might get a slight price cut out of it. Knowing Intel though, that probably won't happen. We did get some price listings, and if we converted them to US dollars, they seem more like placeholder prices than actual retail prices. The other thing that is unclear is if only the graphics part of the CPU will be locked out. I mean, there are other video related parts of the die like quick sync video, and I hope that they don't remove it since it's quite powerful for video processing. Anyways, it seems like Intel is still going to milk their 9th gen CPUs since those might make an appearance during CES in January. Then we have what could be the new successor to the GTX 1050. The picture screenshotted by Tom Apisak found a card from Nvidia with no specific name on Geekbench. What we can see from the Geekbench page is that the GPU has 14 compute units and 4 GB of RAM. 14 compute units would equate to around 896 CUDA cores. That's 256 more than a regular 1050, but of course it would probably be on the Turing platform in this case. The difference between this card and the 2060 is quite large since the 2060 is expected to reach 1920 CUDA cores. The difference here is still very similar to the 1060 versus the 1050, which also saw around double the CUDA cores for the 1060. If we go with what we know from previous generations, this will probably not be a Ti variant. The clock speed of 1560 MHz does point towards it having either GDDR5 or GDDR5X memory. For the naming scheme, I mean, some report that we will have two versions of certain cards. For example, an RTX 2060 and a GTX 1160. And apparently the 50 versions of the cards will also get the same treatment, but I think that this would just cause massive confusion. While I do want more cards at better prices without RTX, I just don't think that it's a great idea unless those cards are based on Pascal and are super cheap. This might be a way to counter whatever AMD has in mind with the Navi cards. What do you guys think? Do you think it's a smart move from Nvidia? Let me know down below. Moving on the AMD side, they released the bigger brothers to the Athlon 200GE. The 220GE and 240GE are pretty much an exact copy of the 200GE, but with faster clock speeds. Now, if you go for an MSI motherboard, those two CPUs are actually kind of pointless. As we saw a few weeks ago, MSI motherboards have the capability to overclock the 200GE, and so far, testing shows that you can easily expect a stable 3.8 GHz. In comparison, the highest of the three current Athlon clock in at 3.5 GHz for the 240GE, so it's already slower. Now, the MSI mistake that allows for overclocking on these chips will be patched, so if you want one, you might want to consider going for it now. It's kind of reminiscent to what happened with the Intel 8400 CPU. I wonder if any of you guys are running an overclocked 8400. Let me know down below. All right, so the news have been kind of slow with the holiday period happening right now, so I thought, why not schedule a live stream with you guys and talk about what's new. Make sure you hit that notification bell near the subscribe button down there, that way you'll get notified when it will happen and when it will go live. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Make sure you stay frosty and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Take care!